In this example, we're going to look at combustion analysis, where we oxidize a compound containing carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen, and we're told how many grams of water and how many grams of carbon dioxide form when the reaction is complete. We want to know the empirical formula. So I'm going to demonstrate how I would solve this problem. Since I have not looked at it before, what I first want to do is write down what I know and what I'm trying to determine. And so we have a compound. What we don't know, let me call them X, Y, and Z. We don't know the values of X, Y, and Z. We do know we start with 1 gram. We're going to react it with oxygen. I don't know the number of moles, but I'm going to make CO2 and water as my only two products. And we're given that we have 2.818 grams of CO2 and 1.161 grams of water. And so what we want to do is convert the CO2 grams to moles, and likewise convert the water grams to moles, so we can then determine the moles of carbon and the moles of hydrogen in our starting compound. And then we're going to use the total weight to determine the moles of oxygen, because we can't use the oxygen here to determine that, since we're adding a large amount of oxygen to carry out the oxidation. So that means the first thing I want to do is look up the atomic mass, carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen in a periodic table. I can then use these to calculate first the molecular mass of CO2, and that's going to be 1 carbon plus 2 oxygens. And I can calculate that mass. I'm going to do the same thing for water. It's going to be 2 hydrogens plus 1 oxygen. In both cases, this is going to be the number of grams per mole. So I'll use my calculator to get the values. And so I can calculate the moles of CO2. I have 2.818 grams and 44.008 grams per mole. Units cancel. This will be the moles of CO2. And then likewise, I can calculate the moles of water. 1.161 grams of water, and the molecular mass, grams per mole, and this will be the moles of water. So let me calculate those numbers. And so this tells me I have then 0.0640 moles of carbon in my starting compound. And I have, since this is H2O, for every mole of water, I have 2 moles of hydrogen, so 2 times 0.0644 moles of hydrogen. So I need to now go back and calculate the mass of 0.0640 moles of carbon, and likewise the mass of hydrogen that's in my original compound. So I have 0.0640 moles of carbon and 12.01 grams of carbon per mole. So this gives me the grams of carbon in my starting compound. And I do the same thing for hydrogen. I have 2 times 0.0644 moles of hydrogen atoms. There's 1.008 grams per mole for a hydrogen. So this is going to be the grams of hydrogen, my starting compound. So let me calculate these numbers. I start out with 1 gram of my compound. We now know that 0.7690 grams are carbon. So if I subtract that from the total, and then I subtract the mass of hydrogen, this will be the mass of oxygen in my starting compound. So now I have the number of grams of oxygen. So I'm going to have to convert that back to moles of oxygen to get the empirical formula. 15.999 grams per mole. This will give me the moles of oxygen. So I'm almost finished now. I have the moles of carbon. Let's look here. And moles of carbon, moles of hydrogen, and moles of oxygen in the compound. So let me rewrite those. So what I'm going to do is divide all the numbers by 0.00631. So this becomes 1. And then the other two numbers are... Now I'm going to assume within the accuracy of the measurement that this is 20, 10, and 1. So they have C10, H20, O1. That's the empirical formula for my starting compound.